Hey everybody, it's Mike from AMZ Advisors, and today I'm going to be talking to you about A to Z claims on the Amazon platform. So first of all, what is an A to Z claim on Amazon? So customers can make A to Z claims when they are buying products from third-party sellers on the platform, and they can make these claims if they're not happy with the service of the product, with the communication with the seller, for a variety of different issues. But the main reasons are that the product didn't show up on time. The product was late. It was not as described. They were misled on some aspect of the listing. Those are a lot of different reasons that they will submit A to Z claims. And then the seller needs to respond to those A to Z claims before Amazon allows a chargeback from the customer if the seller is unwilling to do the refund. The A to Z claim offers a level of protection for customers so that they know that they are going to get a product and they can buy something trustworthy through the Amazon platform. At the same time, it requires sellers to be on top of their game on the Amazon platform to make sure that they're fulfilling customer orders in time, they're not having issues with their product, and their product is actually as described on the platform. A customer needs to initially message you as the seller to begin the process to file an A to Z claim, and they need to try to resolve whatever issue it is with talking with you first. And if at some point you're not able to come to an agreement, they may file the A to Z claim with Amazon. And at that point, you'll need to deal with responding to Amazon and the customer as well to explain the situation and why you don't think that you should be responsible for giving them a refund on the basis of this A to Z claim. There are a few reasons that a customer can file an A to Z claim. One of them being that the product was not delivered within 3 days of the promised delivery date that you've made. The product is received in damaged or not a working order. The product is different to the product that you were advertised. That's a big issue, and that can cause a lot of problems for you on the Amazon platform. Another reason could be on international orders. If you're not providing a return label for the customer, they could file an A to Z claim. Or if you won't reimburse them for unexpected costs with sending the product internationally, they can also file an A to Z claim against you to get a refund for that amount of money. And finally, the sellers have 90 days to actually submit an A to Z claim from the date they purchased it. So there's a limited time that they have to submit an A to Z claim. As a seller, there's a few things that you can do to avoid getting A to Z claims. The first one is obviously to sell a good product. Make sure that your product that is being shipped to the customer is in good condition. And prior to that, the product you're sending to Amazon is in good condition. A lot of times, if you're buying a product directly from Asia or wherever you're manufacturing the product, you may be sending it directly to the Amazon warehouse. You really don't know what the manufacturer is sending you, so it's always important to check it before it gets to Amazon. You also want to make sure that you're accurately describing your products on your product listing pages, and you're not misleading customers on what they're actually buying, and it's not providing a benefit or has a feature that your product can't actually deliver on. And then finally, you really want to make sure that your shipping is on time. If you run into shipping issues, that's going to cause a lot of problems with the A to Z claims, and that can cause issues with your order effect rates, which will have additional knock-on effects with your overall Amazon account health, and worst case scenario could actually get your Amazon account shut down. Additionally, clearly communicating with the customer and providing good customer service is another great way to avoid getting A to Z claims against you. By communicating clearly, you can actually resolve a lot of the issues ahead of time and prevent them from causing additional issues with your Seller Central account. So if you've received an A to Z claim, how do you deal with it? And the first thing you need to think about is, has the customer clearly communicated what the issue is? And if they haven't, you need to reach out to them for more details so you can do some research on your end to see exactly what happened. You're going to want to check when the product was marked as delivered by whoever the carrier was, what the records actually show to either support or refute their claim. And then you're going to need to have that information to communicate it with Amazon. It's also important to communicate clearly and to address the matter quickly. When you receive an A to Z claim, you should let the buyer know that you received the A to Z claim, be apologetic, let them know that you know, this isn't what you intended. Let's try to get to the bottom of this and figure out what the issue is. And you also need to be quick because you only have 3 days to respond to an A to Z claim on the Amazon platform. So rapid communication, quick responses is the best way to make sure that you can appeal or fight your A to Z claims or get them resolved in an amicable manner. Sometimes the issue isn't your fault though. A lot of times you can have an A to Z claim filed against you because of something that Amazon did. And when that's the case, you need to let the seller know that. You don't want to just accept it and refund them. You could separately refund them if you want to through your platform. But if it's an Amazon issue, you want to send it over to Amazon, let them know like, hey, this is your fault. I didn't do anything here. And then that's one way to make sure that you don't get a mark against you for your order defect rate. And then down the road, if Amazon actually is going to side with the customer on the A to Z claim and you feel that that's not correct, you can also appeal it. Show all the communications you have with the customer, what the facts show, why you believe that you're not responsible for this A to Z claim. And then that will help you potentially win your appeal. And again, avoid the damage that an order defect rate can do to your account, having to deal with the A to Z claim can do, having to deal with the A to Z claim in general. And it can just make things a lot better for you as a seller. And to sum it all up, the best way to avoid these A to Z claims is just by providing good customer service, making sure your product is accurately portrayed on the Amazon platform, and making sure your fulfillment is accurate and can get there in the time windows that you put on the platform if you are not using FBA. You also want to make sure that you are clearly communicating with the customer, documenting everything so you have a record of it when you need to talk to Amazon. And then if it is Amazon's fault, make sure you're pushing it over to them. If you'd like to learn more about A to Z claims, you could check out our blog on A to Z claims where you can see more detailed information on all of these aspects of dealing with an A to Z claim. Or if you'd like to learn more in general about selling on Amazon, you can also check out our blog or subscribe to our channel and turn on your notifications, not ours, so that you are updated when AMZ Advisors is putting out the latest videos on the Amazon platform. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day.